Welcome to this step where we would set up a project using Spring Initializer. We would want to build our RESTful web services. What we'll do is we'll use start.spring.io to initialize our Spring project. We would want to generate a Maven project because Maven is the build tool that we are going to use. Language is Java. And we would want to use a Spring Boot version greater than 2.0.0. So select anything which is greater than 2.00 snapshot, you should be fine. The other things we want to specify is the group ID. I would want to use the group ID com in 28 minutes REST web services, and I would put an artifact RESTful web services. For any Maven project, we need to give you a group ID and an artifact ID. You can kind of compare this like a class name and package. We would also want to add a few dependencies. The way you can select dependencies is by typing in them in. So I would want to select web, that's this Spring Boot Starter Web dependency. We are going to build RESTful web services. And if you remember the things from our startup projects, you'd remember that Spring Boot Starter Web is the starter for developing RESTful web services. It is also the starter for developing web applications. Now, I would want to also add in DevTools. DevTools makes it easy for developing applications, so I'll add DevTools in. And I would want to use JPA at a later point in this course, JPA. And I would want to use H2 as the in-memory database. Let's add it in as well. Once you do that, you can click Generate Project. What Spring Initializer does is it would create a Maven project, put it in a zip, and that's what is downloaded to your downloads folder. What I recommend you to do is to unzip the zip file to some folder on your hard disk. The zip file is downloaded. You can take this, unzip the file to some folder on your local hard disk and launch up Eclipse. Once Eclipse launches up, you can import the project by using File, Import, Existing Maven Projects, and you can browse through to the directory where you unzipped your zip file to. This is the root directory to which I unzipped my zip file to, and I can see a pom.xml coming up with RESTful web services. You can also use browse to browse through to your folder. Once I click finish button, what Maven does is it would actually download all the dependencies which are listed in the pom.xml. And it would also set up the entire project for us. So let's go ahead and click the finish button. This might take a little while if this is the first time you are using this specific version of Spring Boot, because this downloads a lot of Maven dependencies. What is happening in the background is the complete setup of our RESTful web services projects. Once the project is set up, you would see a folder structure like this. This is typical Maven project structure. Source main Java, source main resources, source test Java. Source main Java contains all our Java code. I mean, there's not a lot in here right now. We have source main resources with the properties file. So there's application.properties, which is the Spring Boot properties file. And we have the tests, which can be written down in source test Java. We also have a pom.xml, which contains the dependencies which we have chosen. The pom.xml contains the dependencies starter data JPA, starter web, dev tools, H2, and starter test. These four, the first four dependencies are what we have chosen on the start.spring.io website, web, dev tools, JPA, and H2. That's what we chose. And those were the dependencies which were in here. And by default, Spring Boot would add in Spring Initializer would add in a dependency on Spring Boot Starter Test. This is the one to write your unit tests and integration tests. If you go and look at your Maven dependencies, you should see a lot of dependencies which are coming in because of the starters we are using. Now that we have an overview of the project that we are looking at, let's start up the Spring Boot application class. Right-click, Run As, Java application. We have not really written any code as of now, but that's fine. We will write a lot of code in the next steps. For now, what we wanted to check is if the application is launching up fine. If the application launches up fine, then we are good to go. You can see that there is a lot of log being generated, and you would see by the end of the thing that the Tomcat server has started up. So you can see that Tomcat has started on port 8080. There's a lot of magic which is happening in the background. We will uncover all that magic in the subsequent steps as we develop more and more RESTful web services. Until the next step, bye-bye.